So let's move on to the next library or next package. So let's have a look at this on the graphical browser. So this needs util macros, which we have already installed, I think. Yes, we have. And it looks like we'll once again into relatively straightforward packages after this little hiatus. So it looks like, from what I could see when I was looking about compiling Mesa, as it says on the page, LLVM was recommended, not actually mandatory. So it could have been, it certainly looked like, because it didn't have any effect on the problem that I had, it looks like you could get away with building Mesa without LLVM and then just build LLVM with all the dependencies and rebuild Mesa after you've done that. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to rebuild it again, which is a bit of a shame because it does take a while. Right, I've already done that, so let's do yes. Xbitmaps. So straightforward configure. And a make install. And that's done. So now we go on to Xorg Applications, and this is another chapter or section where there's a script to rebuild things. And it looks like we need some dependencies installed. So we haven't got LibPNG yet, so I'll bring that up. We've done Mesa. We've just done Xbitmaps, and we've already done that one as well. We've got Linux PAM, so that's good. So you can see this is another one where there's scripts to run. But first we need LibPNG. Have a quick look at that. I think this is relatively straightforward. Yeah, it is. Okay, so let's do libpng first. So there's the package there to download. Oh, okay. So you could see there that that didn't download correctly. So I'm going to remove that. What I'm going to do is to try and download this with wget, because it does seem that Lynx has problems sometimes with these redirections. So let's type wget, see how this copes. Right, that seems like it's also got confused with the file name. Now, I don't know whether that is the file or not. It looks like it might, because it's about a megabyte by the looks of it. So I'll go back here and copy just the file name and rename this download to what it should be. Then I'm going to extract, or attempt to extract. Yep, that's worked. Yeah, it's extracted. So that's good. Also, there was another download here. Recommended patch to include animated PNG functionality in LibPNG. Required to use the system LibPNG in Firefox, CMonkey, and Thunderbird. So let's try and download this one. I assume this is going to have the same problem. Yeah, it has. What I'm going to do this time is to see if I can change the name here. So save to disk, rub that name out, paste what I've just copied, in, it's saved. So now let's, we've extracted it. Okay, so the first command is to unzip the patch that we've just downloaded. So let's see if that works. No, it's not a zip format. So what I need to do is to do the same as I did before. I'll grab the URL for the patch. Use wget, I'll just go back here. Use wget to fetch it. Okay, this time it's named it correctly, although because I haven't deleted the version that was invalid, it's actually renamed the one that's downloaded. So I need to remove the bad version and rename the good version with the .1 to a name without the .1. Then I can go back into PNG and retry this patch command, and yes, that's worked. And now I can do configure. I don't think there's anything else there. No. Configure and make. That's complete. So run some tests.